If you'd like to get some cheaper models and support the channel, please use the affiliate link below. Thank you. Now on to the video.
Hello and welcome to today's video. Just changed the format slightly, so please pop in the comments whether you like the format of today's video or you prefer previous ones where I've gone through the community page. Now, on to the video. So they have released the rules for the Desolation Squad today, and they look quite interesting. They look like they're trying to do what the old Missile Launcher Squad did for the Devastators, but it's more you must choose one of two profiles. With the Devastator Squad, you have the heavy one with the solid shot, which would be strength 8, and then you've got the more frag style, I think it is, where it's strength 4, but it's more shots. So with the Desolation Squad, you need to choose which way you want to go. So you get a selection of guns in the squad. You get a super frag rocket launcher or a super crack rocket launcher. They're your choices. So your first one is a super frag rocket launcher, which is a heavy D3 plus 3, strength 4, AP 1, damage 1. And it's got blast as well, so against 6 models, 6 to 10 models, it's going to do at least 3. So that will give you your 6 shots, which would be quite interesting. Very good for killing hordes, so if you are fighting a squad of orc boys, having a guaranteed 6 shots for 4 people is very good. 24 shots at strength 4, quite handy. If I remember right, orcs are toughness 5 though, so maybe not a great deal of wounds coming through. It is AP1, so you will chip away. A higher AP would be better, but if this is your general scattershot kind of style, AP1 makes sense. Second one is the super crack rocket launcher. This is more of your tank killing elite infantry terminator kind of killing weaponry. You only get one shot with it. It's a heavy one, so strength 8, AP 3, D3 plus 3 damage. So if you're chosen Codex Warfare, be quite handy at killing tanks. You get 4 shots with it with the squad. Strength 8, most tanks toughness 7. So you'd be wounding most things on 3s. AP 3, make sure that most tanks are being wounded on 6s unless it's like a Land Raider. And then you're basically doing a flat damage of 4, which isn't too bad. If all 4 go through, that's 16, so that should be a dead tank, really, unless you're shooting it like a Repulsor or an Imperial Knight. Annoys me how there's 2 missile ports, but it's only a heavy one. But enough said on that. Your next one is your options for the Sergeant. So it's the Vanguard launcher. Only the Sergeant can have it. It's 48 inch range, it's heavy D6, strength 6, AP 1, and damage 2. Not mad keen on this because it doesn't fully marry up to either of the other guns, because your super frag was strength 4 and your super crack was strength 8. So it doesn't marry up there. The AP makes you want to go for to marry it up with the super frag because it's AP1, but it's damage 2, which is not bad at killing marines or other tough or other 2 wound models. It's I feel that I'd rather take either all super frags or all super cracks, but not sure. Also on the back here, it looks like an old Signum from the old Devastator Squad. So in that case, if it's the old Signum, you would get plus 1 to hit on the squad. So he would sacrifice his shooting to give plus 1 to shoot. I'm not sure if that's still the same rule because I've not run Devastator Squads in quite a while. And the final gun is the Castellan Launcher. Now, this is the little mini gun rocket pod thing there that is on all of the guns. So you get five of these in every squad, and it's 36 inch range, heavy D3, strength 4, AP 1. So the strength 4 and AP 1 tells me it would complement the super frag quite well at horde clearing, but it's a nice option to have on your super cracks as well, because your super cracks will take out the tanks, and then you could arguably shoot these at more infantry to try and clear some up, or if you've got rid of all the tanks, or if you're shooting at Terminators or equivalent tough elite units like Possessed or other things like that. Could be quite good. But what's really nice about it is it has the blast keyword, and it can target units that it can't see, so it doesn't need line of sight, which is handy if you want to pop something that's hiding behind a building or behind a tank or something that you can't see, but it's going to cause you a little bit of problem in an upcoming turn or clearing something off an objective. So it is quite useful for that. My overall impressions are that the 48 inch range and 36 range on the weapons is generally quite handy and useful. Means that they can have more of a backfield role, which is good if you've taken raised banners or you have to hold your backfield objective to have the CP or any other rules in the mission, so that's quite good. And then doing actions is very helpful. Thank you for watching the video. If you've got any comments, please put them below. If you like this format, please let me know, and I'll try and do a few more in this style. Thank you for watching.